So thank you so much for joining us for another edition of Team Superheroes. As always, I'm really stoked about what we're chatting through today. Would you mind introducing yourself, Prem?
My name is Prem Mathiyalagan. I'm a program manager with Microsoft Teams here. I work on the app platform within Microsoft Teams. I come in every day thinking about how every user that uses Teams can bring the tools that they use on a daily basis within Teams. So it's part of the conversations that I have every day to just get their work done as quickly and as efficiently as possible. So some of the things that I work on a daily basis is the app catalog within Teams, where users can go and explore the various apps that we have in Teams.
Just to clarify, for everybody watching, app catalog, and when you reference that, we're talking bottom left-hand side of your Teams desktop application where you click on it and you've got the app store sitting there, right?
That's exactly right. Cool. So there's an apps button on the left-hand side of Teams. If you go in, that has all the different apps that we have within Teams that you can bring in to your Teams and channels and start using them. And there's other experiences within Teams as well where you can use apps on a daily basis that I also think about. The big thing for us is to kind of make it feel like the apps that every user needs to get their work done quickly and efficiently is available to them at their fingertips, where they need them, and when they need them.
Awesome. Right. But for me, it's not just about bringing apps into Teams, because yes, there is some inherent value to that. You have conversation around the applications and you have your teams and your groups, but it's how does that application become more? How is it easier for me to interact with that application inside of Teams? I mean, this is core to what you guys are working on, right? Which I find so exciting.
Exactly. Yeah. And like, if you think about it, on a day-to-day basis, to get something done, a user or customers, they have to communicate with the rest of their team, right?
Sure.
On a daily basis. Really work gets done as part of these conversations. Tools are just a means for you to get something done, right? And when we bring these tools in context of these conversations, that's where we light up the value for users.
Sure. You know, back to one of the first things we spoke about here, I think this is an incredibly important point, because it's not just about integration for integration's sake.
Yeah.
Because if we're being really honest, if somebody's a savvy user of technology, while there's absolutely a ton of value to having applications alongside conversations, I want it to be more, right? Like, I want to get more out of my apps and for them to follow me across the canvas of Teams. So I don't even need to context switch in Teams itself.
Exactly.
And so what you guys are doing there is just incredibly valuable, I think, for everybody. But I love that your mindset's also on the end user, not just the technically savvy person who will go figure it out themselves.
Yeah.
So thinking about why you guys are doing this, we kind of talked through, but maybe if you could walk through some of the details on what you're working on in specifics around the application experience inside of Teams. And I just want to clarify for everybody watching, this isn't just Microsoft apps, right? This is applicable to partners, this is applicable to organizations who have built their own homegrown or line of business solutions in Teams, is that correct?
That's absolutely correct. If you think about the app catalog within Teams, we have the obvious candidates like Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Planner. On top of it, we have our external partners that bring their tools into Teams. So some examples are apps like Trello, MindMeister, InVision, and there's hundreds of apps within the catalog.
Lots of good ones coming too.
Yeah, and lots of new ones coming up too. And on top of it, every company, they've started building their own apps so they can bring the tool sets needed within that company to be available for all of the users that's using Teams. So these are the line of business apps that's available.
I think this one's really cool, right? Because it takes we start thinking about these applications beyond just the ones that are there for productivity, even though all of this is in the context of productivity, right, and collaboration. But it's these HR resources, these IT support, it's project management, all these tools that aren't necessarily always related to what we think about when it comes to office. And now we're bringing that together. And it's this cool, amazing space that you guys have created with Teams that has been fantastic.
Exactly. And one of the recent features that we shipped for Teams actually is a good manifestation of this. We have the app layout on the left side of Teams. So if users click on the dot, dot, dot button, you can see all the apps that's available for users. One of the things we've done now is we've implemented a new grid layout. So it's much more usable for users, right? Like, they have a good sense of what apps are available to them. And on top of it, we also integrated search right on top of it. So even if a user wants to use an external app in that context, if they wanted to use one of the line of business apps published by their company in that context, they can quickly search for it and then start using it.
Awesome.
Like without having to leave what they were trying to do, like without having to jump to this catalog page and find this app, they can just get it right there. Again, this is to kind of deliver on the apps feel available to users where they need them and when they need them philosophy, right?
Love so that.
That's a good example.
So you're not bouncing back and forth even in Teams anymore at that point, right? That's killer. Hey, so real quick, I forgot about this when I mentioned it earlier. If I'm a user and I watch this video and I click on my bottom left hand side of Teams and go to the catalog and it's not empty necessarily, but there's fewer apps. Why is that?
Well, so obviously Teams is a big enterprise product and we want to make sure that the IT admins of every company, they have full control over what's available to their users. So one of the things we provide to IT admins within every company is this option for them to limit access to a certain apps within their company for whatever reason.
I was really excited about this feature that I got to test because I'm on the early engineering builds recently, but how much can we talk about user app pinning?
Oh yeah, I would love to talk about user app pinning. That's probably a crown jewel in some of the things that we've done recently in the user experiences. So again, this is not a feature that's been fully rolled out yet. It's available to our beta users now, and we are looking to roll this out broadly. What we've had so far is that users have to click the dot, 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 and then select the app that they want to use.
Sure.
We've improved that experience, but we've also noticed that there is a select few apps that people need on a daily basis to get things done. So now what we provide users is that they can simply go to the dot, dot, dot flyout, and then right click on the app that they use on a daily basis and pin it onto the left side of Teams. So right now, it's at their fingertips.
I think one point maybe we clarify on that too is that if this hasn't rolled out to a certain organization, tenant admins can do this today for users, right? And what I've found a lot of organizations have found really compelling as a way to start is how do you take something like a adoption and change management tool or a website that you use internally to educate your people how to use technology and pin that in Teams. So teaching people to use Teams in Teams is one simple example. And obviously the possibilities are endless, but I love that we're making it more personal for the end user as well, so I can customize my experience. That's awesome.
Yeah, this is really just to cater to the unique needs that every user would have within that organization. Yeah.
So the other thing we were chatting about earlier too was app install flow. Yeah. Can you talk to us about what you're working on there? And to clarify there, so I'm a user, I want to, like you mentioned Trello earlier, I want to bring Trello into my Teams experience. So I go click on the store icon, I go in, and it's that experience right there. How do we make that simpler, right?
Yeah. Exactly. So what we've done in the new install flow, like if a user goes to apps on the bottom left-hand side of Teams, is they can select an app. And now we have a slightly larger canvas with screenshots and videos as the centerpiece, right? We've learned from our user research that users use these screenshots as a valuable piece of information to understand how each app works, right? So that's the centerpiece. And then now we also have better descriptions for every app. And we have a simple call to action, which is just an add button for users, right? So it's super clean. I love how it's turned out. And I love the fact that we have videos and screenshots as the centerpiece of it. And and users can just click the add button and start using the app.
So I know there's only certain things that we can share with all the goodness that you guys are working on next, because this video will, of course, be publicly available. Yeah. But is there anything that we can share on what your team, even if just what you're thinking about as the next evolution of what you're building?
One of the things that we're working on that I'm super excited about is this concept of like if a user uses an app once, like for themselves or in any of their teams, we're trying to make it available across all the teams, channels, and chats that they're part of, right? As they start using the other channels.
So the app follows you, basically.
The app basically follows the user, right? This doesn't mean that once you add it in one place, it's installed everywhere for you, because that would be bad. This is just to make sure that the app is available to them at the top level, like where they need it, right? So this I'm super excited about, because in this case, if I'm a user of a given tool, it's highly likely that I would want to use it in other conversations that I'm part of. So we'll take an example, right? If I use Trello, I'll pick that as an example, and I've used it to pin a board to a team and I'm working in another team, and I go to the tab gallery. Sure. This is when you click on the plus button at the top of Teams. Trello would be one of the apps that's already available in the team.
Nice.
And the user can just click it and start using it. They don't have to go back into the catalog to go find for it. They don't have to go search for it. It's just right there, right? We're trying to also continue to look at how we can build overall relevance of how these apps are surfaced to the user. And this doesn't just include the tab gallery. This is when you click on the plus button. This also includes how apps are surfaced within the catalog itself, like how we can make it just more relevant. So the app that might be useful to that given user, that's more prominently placed as opposed to users having to go hunt for them. So these are a couple of features that we're super excited about. Should be rolling out in the next, you know, months, few months.
In terms of if I want to start leveraging applications in Teams, where would you recommend me to go first as an end user?
The one place I would recommend you go to is the apps button on the left-hand side, bottom left-hand side of Teams. That would have the full selection of apps that we have. And you can start using your favorite app.
Yeah.
The catalog would also have any apps that your company might have published for you guys.
And a reminder that if you go look and see it, you only see a few apps on there, you don't see any in some cases, make sure you reach out to your IT department because they're the ones who have the ability to determine which apps you can see in that store.
Exactly.
So this is awesome. Prem, you're a legend, dude. Thank you so much for spending
the time.
It's awesome to have you on here. Our first actual engineer too on the call, so it's great to have you here and hear all the work that you guys are doing. So appreciate your time, man.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Cheers.
Cheers.